I'm Paul, and welcome to this piano lesson on Chopin's Polonaise in G minor. In this video, we'll look together at a little background history and then go through the piece in sections. This is an intermediary level piano lesson. So, let's start with a little history. Chopin composed this Polonaise when he was only 7 years old. Some say it was his first piece, but others that the Polonaise in B flat was actually his first piece. The young Frederick's father was so amazed by his son's talent, he gave the score to a vicar in the parish of Virgin Mary in Warsaw, the capital of Poland, who published it. The original manuscript doesn't seem to have survived, and on the cover it says Chopin was 8, but in fact he was actually just 7. This Polonaise has 3 distinct moods and is basically divided into 4 sections. Each section is repeated. Let's think of these moods as pictures. Section 1 could be a stormy landscape in G minor. Section 2, the sky brightens as we change to the related key of B flat major. Section 3, villagers dance a polonaise. Remember, a polonaise is actually a Polish dance. Section 4, the villagers, now a little tired, have their final dance of the afternoon. And the piece comes full circle with a repetition of section 1. The sky moody and the sun goes behind the clouds. This Polonaise has lots of dynamic colour and variety. I'll play a few bars from the opening section. First, without thought for the best fingering or any attention to crescendo and diminuendo. Then I'll play it again with a bit more attention to fingering and dynamics. Find your singing voice in your fingers. Here's another few bars played twice. The first time I'll play without any thought for the melody whatsoever. The second time I'll try to play with attention to the melody in the right hand, which I hope will sing out a little above the accompaniment in the left hand. The first chord can be bold, in forte, and the second just a little quieter. Notice the D is held as you change to the second chord. This helps your hand turn smoothly if you use the D to balance your wrist. One thing to watch out for. Notice it's a crotchet chord followed by a quaver chord. Not 2 crotchet chords, so don't hold the quaver chord too long. This crotchet-quaver combination makes the rhythm interesting right from the beginning. The upper note in the right hand sings the melody, even though it's a chord. So you can voice the chord by putting a little more weight on this note. The important thing is not to let any of the other notes dominate this top note, or the melody will be lost. An arpeggio of G minor, like a sudden gust of wind, takes us from the very bottom of the piano to a melody note. This song is gentle and mysterious, like a forest in the snow under moonlight. The arpeggio can be practiced as chords until you are used to finding the positions. Start off quietly, like a gust of wind building up, and reach towards the melody note at the top, which must stand out. Make sure all the notes you play before this melody note are not as loud as this note, or it won't stand out. The melody is divided into two phrases, so you can give a little breath between each phrase, as if you were really singing instead of playing. We change to B flat major, which is the relative major of G minor, so the key signature stays the same. Similar to the opening chords, a note is held. This time it's F, so use this note to turn your wrists smoothly to join the chords. We hear the same fanfare from the opening passed into B flat major. Again, make sure you don't lose the melody note at the top, or the fanfare's tune will get lost. The first melody in G minor we had to sing with our fingers, the mood was a little melancholy and mysterious. This new melody in B flat is cheerful and bouncy. Notice the left hand is divided into groups of two, with a slur to connect both notes. So we need to make these pairs of notes by slightly lifting our wrists between each pair. I'll play them as written and then as if they were written as a group of four instead, so you can hear the difference. In this section, I imagine a village dance, the Polonaise, on a sunny afternoon. It's light-hearted, and the dynamics are not the same throughout. The levels change, starting quietly, getting louder, and back to quiet again. The trick to playing quickly is to think ahead, rather than search for the notes to play on the spur of the moment. What I mean is, all these semiquavers might look complicated to play, but really, they're just chords. So if you find the chord shape first, then play, you'll find this section comfortable to play and not slip onto a note you hadn't intended to play, better known as a wrong note. This section is similar to the preceding. The villagers are a little tired now, having the final dance of the day. As evening falls, the storm clouds gather and we lead back to a repetition of the opening section in G minor. Thank you. Now I'll play the whole Polonaise with the repeats, and afterwards you can follow again with the score. Good luck with your Polonaise, and thanks for watching.